for the mighty electromagnetic experiments of Nikola Tesla in 1908. Funding had run out for the last time. The engineering genius would receive no more handouts from banking magnate J.P. Morgan. In today's dollars, Tesla was now $500,000 in debt. And to attract new investors, he would first need to capture the attention of the public. The desperate inventor needed to give his first demonstration of his power to destroy. Wardenclyffe was the massive tower proposed by Nikola Tesla to generate ungodly levels of electrical energy. To transmit this power without wires through the air. The North American power grid is limited to the transfer of 1 million kilowatts by wire. Wardenclyffe was designed to release a charge 1,000 times as large, measured in terawatts. When projected, the energy of this discharge would be equal in force to a nuclear strike. Robber Baron J.P. Morgan, in exchange for 51% ownership of the project, bankrolled the construction of Wardenclyffe Tower. Almost immediately thereafter, Morgan found himself mired in the stock market panic of 1901. He was also the one who started the panic. It was Tesla's bad luck, several years later, that he came begging for more money during the banker's crisis of 1907. He was told by Morgan there was none to be had. Morgan would pass away before the Roaring Twenties, and his net worth became the source of much gossip. John D. Rockefeller then told the press that Morgan had never been a wealthy man. New investors were needed. In Italy, the inventor Marconi had succeeded in using radio to become the first man on Earth to transmit wireless messages. This innovation was originally promised by Tesla. The American press then turned on Tesla, accusing him of fraud. He needed to stage an event that would make headlines around the world. He would unleash the full potential of Wardenclyffe Tower, creating at long range an explosion with the power of a hydrogen warhead. This was more than 30 years before the development of atomic weapons. Naturally, the test site would need to be uninhabited. Tesla dispatched an operative to Washington, D.C., 3 months before the explosion. We're at the Library of Congress. His agent acquired aerial photographs of the North Pole. A record of this request is still on file at the library. The photos confirmed that no one lived within 100 miles of the pole. Explorer Robert Peary was in the newspapers also. He was about to leave New York, bound for the Arctic, where his destiny was to share the honor of becoming the first man to reach the North Pole. But he would not make this trip in a single run. He intended to wait until winter's end on Ellesmere Island, until the following year of 1909. Before Peary steamed up the East River, Tesla contacted him, asking him to report back his observations of any unusual atmospheric phenomena. The Arctic explorer promised he would. On June 30th, 1908, Nikola Tesla directed the power of Wardenclyffe in the direction of the Northern Pole. However, in his desperation, a slight error was made in his calculations. Instead of terminating in the Arctic Circle, the electromagnetic strike continued over the top of the world to burst above the Russian forest of Tunguska. Tunguska was in line with the trajectory of the weapon over the pole. The closest Russian observers to the Tunguska explosion at a distance of 15 kilometers was a camp of nomads who were herders of reindeer. Survivors reported their communal tent was lifted into the air with all its occupants. In the distance was seen a channel of bright light descending from the heavens with uncanny resemblance to the beam of a laser.